Hey, Artony, Ollie here. This week, we have seen a seismic shift in the Reason for Death community, from the developers literally getting kicked out of their own Discord servers to the R40 community server's very short-lived life. We have a lot of stuff to cover, including some big news about the Halloween release. Let's go! There are a lot to cover today, so I'll first get the smaller items out of the way. Monday this week, the R4D community server became officially recognized, and I became one of its moderators. On Tuesday morning, the community server opened to the public, and it blew up with the help of Femino's official announcement. By now, you've probably realized something different about this R4D update video. Where are the overly lengthy Discord screenshots? Well, my dear friends, this is where the drama comes in. When Femino joined the community server, he was not pleased. No, not at all. The server was much like the R2D8 Discord server with many of the same issues. In particular, Femino disliked the moderation team and the toxicity in the chat. So the community server's official endorsement was retracted just one day after it opened to the public. Alex, the server owner, is now making a new moderation team, while the developers have put any official community servers on hold. This leads us perfectly into the next topic. What the heck is happening in the official Reason for Death server? Before I go on to share the latest insider news and the Halloween leaks, please consider to like and subscribe for the highest quality Reason for Death updates out there. With the temporary closure of one of the highly anticipated community projects, changes were happening back on the official Reason for Death Discord server. Some personal issues from the developers came to light, and many underlying problems that were previously ignored were brought out. A purge took place among the staff members, resulting in a reorganization of the upper echelons of power. Pimino and Lystar were kicked from the server. In their place, Reason for Death owners came to represent the developers. However, this account will not be nearly the same as before. The debuggers and moderator chats were also combined with the deletion of all previous messages and updates, including the public temp channel. At first glance, these changes don't seem huge. After all that talk, the only real difference is a few less staff members and a different channel name, right? Well, not quite. First, no more are the days of tagging and messaging the developers. Initially, they were extremely engaging with the community. Anyone could directly message Lystar and she would respond. Similarly, in debugger and moderator chats, Pimino could be tagged as well. In recent announcements, new members could no longer message Lystar, and then she could not be reached at all unless you were already connected or were in the staff channels. However, Reason for Death owners, the replacement account of Pimino and Lystar, cannot be reached as of now. Not even for staff members. So if you want to let the developers know something, leave your message in the comments below or message me directly because I'm friends with Lystar. This lack of community engagement, however, is not actually a bad thing in my opinion. I see it as a sign that Pimino and Lystar will be making great strides in releasing R4D as best as they can before Halloween. In some good news, it is now official that R4D will be released, and most likely before the end of October. Debuggers and moderators could likely play the game even earlier than that, so stay tuned for the first look at gameplay. Today is also the last day to redeem a code for an in-game secondary weapon, so join the Discord server via the link in my description to get the code as soon as possible. Regarding the Halloween event and R4D as a demo, when the official public version comes out, all of our stuff will still be kept, so no need to worry about our efforts going to waste. Special thanks to Alex and Fab for sharing their news. I recently covered a tour of one of the unused Halloween maps right here if you haven't seen it, and I also have map tours of future, completely unpublicized maps coming up. So don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.